case and how he was able to get a top security clearance in the first place. Chief Washington correspondent James Rosen is here with that. Hi there, James.
Heather, good afternoon. Senior officials in the Department of Homeland Security tell Fox News today these reports are simply dredging up matters from as long ago as 2001 and which were exhaustively reviewed by the FBI both times that this official received top security clearance. The individual in question is Christian Marone, the new chief of staff at the Department of Homeland Security. The Washington Times has recently reported on Marone's role as lead prosecution witness in the trial of his own father-in-law and former boss, a powerful state senator in Pennsylvania named Vincent Fumo. A Democrat, Senator Fumo served 4.5 years in prison after being convicted in March 2009 on 137 counts of conspiracy, fraud, and other charges. The Times reports that in emails adduced at trial, Marone proposed to Senator Fumo that they work together to disguise the source of a campaign contribution to Senator Robert Casey, the Pennsylvania Democrat, and that Marone once secured Fumo's approval to hire a private investigator to quote-unquote snoop on the man at Screen Right, then Philadelphia Mayor Ed Rendell. The new Secretary of Homeland Security, Jay Johnson, got to know Christian Marone when they both worked at the Pentagon under Defense Secretary Robert Gates, who, in his much-publicized memoir, Duty, released last month, singled Marone out for praise. None of this information is new, DHS spokesman Peter Bouguard said in a statement, as it was part of a publicly accessible and widely covered federal trial many years ago in which Mr. Marone helped put a corrupt individual behind bars. He has the confidence of two secretaries from two administrations of both parties, unquote. The Philadelphia Inquirer previously reported on the contents of the emails about Mayor Rendell. A trio of Republican lawmakers, nonetheless, has written to DHS demanding more information about Marone's background checks. Heather.
All right, James Rosen, thank you so much.
Is Obamacare a job killer or a job creator? Secretary Sebelius saying that some people are taking a government